Hi there. In this video, I will outline the key challenges as well as solutions for becoming reliant on renewable energy systems. As you already know, there are plenty of solutions for the production of renewable energies. This might be PV, wind, geothermal, or biomass, for instance. But of course, there's a drawback to these beautiful technologies, and we are not there yet that we could say we can fully rely on these sources. Nevertheless, the share of renewables is growing steadily, and many cities have made such a progress that you could actually say that some districts are fully supplied by renewables. Yet, like I said, we are not there yet. We have to tackle several challenges before we can fully replace fossil fuels. This includes an improvement of the necessary physical as well as organizational infrastructure. These are things we still have to develop to bring sustainable energy to everyone. One main problem we have to tackle by this is the so-called intermittency of many renewable energy sources, for instance, like PV. Now, what is intermittency? This term means nothing else that many of the energy sources we have mentioned already are not available all the time in the same quantity. Take solar energy, for example. During daytime, solar energy is plentiful available, but during nighttime, you've got a problem. Furthermore, you've got seasonal and global differences when solar energy is available and how much. So think of the differences in sunlight hours or intensity in winter versus summer. Winter normally has less sunlight hours and a lower solar intensity, while in summertime, more sunlight is available and the intensity is way higher. These differences might be small if you're close to the equator, while farther away from the equator, these differences are huge and even can make the use of solar energy not really favorable. How to overcome the challenge of intermittency? One important way there is not to rely on one energy source only, but to combine them in a smart way to provide energy all the time. So you would combine PV, wind, geothermal, biomass, or whatever else is possible in such a way that you provide energy all the time while the other source might not be that available. To implement this, nevertheless, we have to improve our current energy infrastructures. What we nowadays have is we've got a centralized infrastructure where large-scale power plants provide our electricity, for instance. This electricity only flows in one direction, from the supplier to the consumer, from the power plant to the socket at home. In future, we all will become small-scale energy producers if we install renewables at home. So instead of just being consumers, we also produce. That also means that electricity is not only flowing in one direction, it actually is flowing from where it is produced and in surplus to where it is needed. So in order to distribute all these energy flows, we need to find new ways to organize this to provide sustainable energy as a service to everyone. Here, the use of smart grids and ICT can become powerful tools. Furthermore, storage of energy will be another crucial aspect for our future energy systems. So you must think of using electricity storage devices like batteries to store electricity when it's in surplus, or you must find new ways to store heat and cold. One thing you could apply there is so-called aquifer thermal energy storage. So you would use groundwater as a storage element. What you would do with that, you store heat that is in surplus in summertime and you reuse that in wintertime, while you store cold in the groundwater in winter times and reuse the cold in summertime for cooling your buildings. So, my question to you, when will you start feeding energy into the decentralized network?